Welcome back everyone, and a good morning from the Kyle of Loch Ausch. Thanks for joining back up with us for part 4 of our 2021 scooter tour series around Scotland. Great night's sleep at the Kyle Hotel last night. Think the Iron Monkeys may have had something to do with that. But we've all had breakfast. Gilly's already loaded up and raring to go.
We've set off taking the A87 out of the Kyle of Loch Ausch. 109 miles to do today. The mileage isn't a problem, but the majority of today's riding is along single track 25 mile an hour roads following the Westeros Coastal Trail. Total concentration is the order of the day, as these roads with their twists and undulations can easily catch out the unsuspecting rider. We're looking to make some safe, steady progress on a long morning, and we'll hopefully be able to find a late lunch on the hoof at Torridon or Kinlochhue before a lazy afternoon enjoying the sights along Loch Maree and at Gairloch. Just approaching Balnacara here on the A87. In a mile and a half at Ausch to Tyre, we need to turn left up the A890 to head north up towards Loch Carron before we link up with the NC500. First stop on this morning shift is the Loch Carron viewpoint, and then on the fourth day of us touring around Scotland, we finally get onto the official North Coast 500 route near Loch Carron, where we need to fill up as it all gets pretty remote for the next stretch. When we start to head over the Bealach Na Bá.
The Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá. Bealach Na Bá.
The Applecross Pass.
Bealach Na Bá.
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 So we headed east out of the Kyle of Loch Ausch before picking up the A490 to head north. First stop of the day was the Loch Carron viewpoint on the south side of Loch Carron. There's a nice shot of Chris Wildman with the loch in the background. And look at the handiwork of some juvenile. Eamon, are you 60 or 16? Never mind, I'm sure rabbies.com will be very grateful for you starting off their sticker collection for them.
That's us now circumnavigating our way around Loch Carron. Just going through the twin tunnel at Atterdale there, as you can see. Half of the road traffic, the other half of the train line. Next, it's around the head of Loch Carron and through the tiny hamlet of Strathcarron, which is a little more than half a dozen crofters' cottages and a railway station. But we're at the junction with the 8896. So on the morning of our fourth day riding around Scotland, we've finally made it onto the North Coast 500.
So we've turned west onto the A896, and the first village we come to on the official NC500 route is Loch Carron. The group all pulled into the filling station, and it was obvious with only two pumps they were going to be a bit overwhelmed. Luckily I knew of another self-service refuelling point just down the road that we'd spotted last year, so I suggested six of us head there to ease the congestion at the main garage. After we'd filled up, we pulled over and admired the views from the banks of Loch Carron while we waited a few minutes for the others to come along. It was immediately obvious what had held them up. The first garage they'd come to on the North Coast 500 route, and they'd all seize the opportunity to get the official North Coast 500 stickers for their bikes.
Just riding down a stretch of the A896 through the foothills at Arda Rock. Every picture tells a story. There always seems to be a rogue vehicle in the middle that spoils the shot. Come on, own up. Who let the car in? Making our way to the turnoff at Tornapress for the big one.
The Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
The Applecross Pass.
Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
We're on board here now with Chris Wildman's GoPro. We've had a trouble-free morning so far and have arrived at the Tornapress Junction. This is where we turn left off the A896 to take on the Applecross Pass. For 2021, there's a new sticker-free main signpost that's been put up. The Applecross Pass, Bealach Na Bá. This road rises to a height of 2,053 feet with gradients of 1 in 5 and hairpin bends. Not advised for learner drivers, very large vehicles or caravans and motorhomes after the first mile. Alternative low level route via Shieldig and Kenmore, 7.5 miles. I've done a bit of research for you about this route. It's an unclassified road and is known as both the Applecross Pass or the Bealach Na Bá. The name Bealach Na Bá comes from the Scottish Gaelic language and it translates to the Pass of the Cattle. The route dates back to the early 1800s when it was historically used as a drover's route to get sheep and cows over the Applecross Peninsula. The original road was just made up of rough gravel and was very difficult to clear in the winter. This meant it could be blocked for weeks on end until in 1950 when it was totally paved over and tarmacked. Despite this, there's still snow gates at each end, and in winter it's still regularly shut when it hasn't been cleared of a fresh snowfall. It's a single track road all the way, 11 miles in total length, from Tornapress to Applecross, or vice versa, as you can do the Applecross Pass in both directions, using the passing places as necessary to pull in and let traffic you meet coming in the opposite direction come past you. The Bealach Na Bá route starts off at sea level, close to the sea lock, Loch Kishorn. To start off, section 1 is a gradual incline that traverses across the foothills before it climbs up to get into section 2, the main valley, and eventually up to the hairpin section 3, where the bends are tight and the gradients increase. The final, section 4, is a straightforward ascent to the top of the pass. This road is accredited as being the greatest ascent of any road climb in the UK, rising from sea level at Tornapress or Applecross up to 626 metres or 2,054 feet at the summit. Anyway, we've got a club sticker on one of the signs for the third year running and the group are all raring to go. We're not here to talk about the Bealach Na Bá all day, we're here to ride it. Will and myself are setting off just ahead of the main group to try and get ourselves set up at some good vantage points to get some film footage of the others coming through. This is Dave Cross on the first section I mentioned earlier, where there's a gentle climb that traverses around the foothills overlooking Loch Kishorn. Just on the cardinal sin, gone into a passing point on the opposite side of the road. What it's supposed to do is just wait on our side of the road beside the passing place so that the traffic on the other side can approach us and has room to pull into the passing place on their side of the road. We were hoping to get a free run up here so we have plenty of time to get ourselves into some filming positions. So let's hope this chap doesn't hold us up too long. If he's not in a particular rush, then it's best just to pull over at a passing place and let the faster traffic go through. Then he can enjoy his drive at his own pace. Ah, well done, mate. Here we go. That's where we're heading, over that. We're on board here again with Dave Cross, giving you a rider's eye view, making his way up section 2, along the valley, behind some bikers. This is the overall route over the Bealach Na Bá. But the area we're really interested in is the third section, the area in that little yellow box. The little yellow boxed area is the section with the switchback bends and the gradients of 20%. The yellow dot on the first hairpin is where Will is doing some video. He's going to video the riders coming along the last section of the valley, around the first hairpin and up the next incline. I've set myself up at the next yellow dot, which is about 3/4 of the way up. I'm going to try and cover these areas for you, battling the winds with the drone. So this could possibly be the last time we see any drone footage on this trip. Then Will manages to get near the top of the pass to get a shot of me coming up the final stretch, section 4, before the summit. And finally, we have some footage from Ian Rock, who's done a bit of filming from the very top.
And here comes the remainder of the group, filmed from Chris Wildman's GoPro. That's LML Steve in front with Fingers, Lambretta Jim, Scotch Stevie, Ian Rock in front, being led by Gary Byrne. Bit of fresh tarmac there where they've just recently widened a section of the road. Here's Scotch Gary, he's through the valley section and made it up to the first hairpin on his 1950s Vespa GS. Andre Boldit would be proud of him. Martin's got him on the drone now and he's 3/4 of the way up to the summit. Here's Patrick on his GTS and he's made it to the first switchback by Will. Meanwhile, the Cowenders are just coming into the valley section. Martin's got them on the drone now. That's Dawn down there with Steve Green, Gilly, Steve Wheatley and Stuart Harden close behind. Just completed the valley section and coming onto the first hairpin. As Patrick comes round the bend here and makes steady progress up the third section. Dawn's route now, and down below you can see Eamon finishing the valley section with Nick Wake behind. They'll soon be into the hairpins.
Well, Bealach Na Bá, or as we've all been calling it, Bealach Na Bá. I tell you, if you're looking for an adrenaline rush, that is definitely something to be done. It's not just tootling round town or just your little Sunday jaunts to a pub on your scooter. That is serious riding. Amazing.
Dawn, Steve Green, Gilly, Steve Wheatley and Stuart Harden have almost made it up. Eamon's made it round the first hairpin and here comes Nick. Nick's making good progress on the most challenging third section, and down below you can see Lambretta Jim, LML Steve, Andy Northfield and Ian Rock coming along. Here they are, made it to the first hairpin. Now they're working their way up the third section, whilst we can see Chris Wildman down below, and behind him, way back, is a couple of stragglers. Perhaps they had a job getting past those vans and the motorhome.
Bealach Na Bá, just amazing.
Here's Chris now, made it to the hairpin section. And here he comes, on the drone, almost made it to the top.
Fantastic.
And here comes Gary Byrne and Stella Steve with Kay and me in the vans.
Oh, keep going.
Nice line there, Stephen. Probably the best we've seen.
Gary and Stella Steve, almost there now. I think Stella Steve is ushering them along. I just heard him shout, go, go, go! That's the final hairpin. And they're away, off to the summit. Just Steve Coons and Scott Stevie to get round the last hairpin, and Martin can start to think about getting this drone back in.
We must have got a good few shots, and thankfully it
looks like it's not gone sailing off too far, out of control in these winds. Here's Chris Wildman, just pulling up at the summit car park. Listen to the glee and jubilation. No panic, Scott Stevie just pulled over to get a couple of photos, and here's Will, who's packed his camera and he's making his way to the section 4, the final ascent.
And Will's pulled over to get a quick clip of Martin coming along the final straight. Well done, Will.
Crossway.
We made it, every last one of us, including the vans.
This is so windy. Up here.
As you can hear, the wind is absolutely ferocious, and towards the end I'm sure I can hear a wailing banshee to even add to the frightening excitement we've all just experienced. Need to get out this wind. As the saying goes, what goes up must come down. So as we tackle another arduous descent, we're looking forward to a hot coffee or maybe a hot chocolate at Applecross.
And we've all pulled up at the Applecross Inn, which we knew was closed on a Tuesday, but nevertheless, it's a nice little place and a very handy place for us to regroup. Let's hear from some of the riders.
Applecross Pass, what do you think of that?
All right, mate.
Loved it.
Brilliant.
Loved it. Stewie, thumbs up.
Second time, still as challenging. Fantastic.
The corner was a bit bendy.
The what?
The corner was a bit bendy and it, you know, I took the corner.
Quick for the camera. Bealach Na Bá, what are we saying?
Bealach Na Bá, that was amazing. A bit windy at the top. Absolutely loved it.
Will?
Fucking freezing.
Third time, does it get any easier?
Yeah, actually, I suppose to a degree, but it depends on what point you're at.
Bealach Na Bá then, what's the verdict, Clayman?
Madness.
Brilliant, absolutely fantastic. Fucking cracking roll.
That Bealach Na Bá, well, that was brilliant. Yeah. 11 out of 10. Yeah. Bring it on, let's go again. Yeah. The other way round.
Oh, yeah.
Thank
yeah,
you. How was it? Not as terrifying as I thought it would be. But yeah, very rideable, very enjoyable, I would say.
Bealach Na Bá,
made for Vespas. Awesome.
Absolutely brilliant ride.
the wind and that makes it even better. So coming up there, lovely. Hard, I think harder coming down, but it's great. Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
The Bealach Na Bá.
Bealach Na Bá.
The Applecross Pass.
Bealach Na Bá.
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 So everybody's got across the Bealach Na Bá. It was a bit windy up there, but nobody's lost a wig. Oh, actually, fingers, where's your wig? So, after a brief stop and some stories shared, we're just leaving Applecross. There's Jim on his Lammy and Stella Steve with Gary in front. We're heading around the peninsula along the Wester Ross Coastal Trail now towards Colnachill and Fermoy. It's a single track coastal road all the way. We're on the lookout for a suitable lunch stop, but this area is a bit remote, and the chances are that we'll need to get to Torridon or even Kinlochhue before we find somewhere to cater for our largest group. There's Patrick now on his GTS. Everyone's getting accustomed to the etiquette and what's expected of them on the single track roads by now. And to be fair, the lead rider is creating a through route for all of us. As long as people are keeping up, then everyone following is sailing through without stopping. Stephen Smith there on his LML four-stroke with a fresh exhaust. Great views to the left, across the Inner Sound and to the Isles of Rasay, Rona and Skye where we were yesterday. Just passing Andy Norfield there with Dave Cross on his GTS. Chris Wildman with his kit all strapped to the LXV. Stewie Arden on the black P2. With Eamon on the silver LML Star. Nick Waite in his urban camouflage. Gilly on his Vespa P200. And Steve Green on his 150 Super. And here's another Steve. This is Scotch Stevie. Thank you.
We're heading back towards civilization now, near Shield Aig on Loch Torridon, which is just as well, as we're all getting a bit peckish. Here's Nick Wake and Stewie Harding. That's what I admire about this group. Six of them have done the trip before, and all six are making sure that the new riders are all okay. We saw it earlier with Stella Steve sticking with Gary over the Bealach Na Bá, and now Stewie's hanging back to make sure Nick's going along okay. Ah, here's the main group. It's 1:30 p.m. and just a couple of miles now till we get to our lunch stop. What did we say yesterday about being caught out on a GoPro that's still recording? We look like a right couple of twerps standing in the middle of the road like we've run out of petrol or something. Actually, Andy and I have made it to Torridon Village, but there's no sign of anybody else. We were only with them all 3 miles ago, but we're having to ring up and check where on earth they'd all got to. Time for a couple of photos while we wait.
Halfway through the day, we stop in a little village, Torridon. At a general store, we stock up on sandwiches, crisps, cakes, and we look across to the most amazing view ever while we're meeting our lunch.
Well, this is towards the end of one of my favourite morning rides. The Bealach Na Bá, the Applecross Peninsula and the Westeros Coastal Trail never disappoints. We're gradually now making our way out of the Torridon area. That's Dawn, Will and Andy coming along. Followed by Gary and Stella Steve. Torridon is only a little village, so it's a case of half of us stop there for lunch, whilst the rest of us are heading to Kinlochhue, the next main village. So we'll soon be picking up some snacks and hot drink at Kinlochhue services. And Stella Steve has found himself a new friend.
Yeah.
How cute.
That's so cute.
See? I'm an animal talker. Yeah.
Well, the first part's right.
Dr. Doolittle.
He's back again, look.
What? I'm an animal.
Come on. Here, mate.
Dave.
So lovely, isn't it?
Red Bull connoisseur.
And just to come past, he came out. He decided he wasn't going to wipe me off.
So everybody's fed and watered and everybody's caught up at Kinlochhue services. Just filling up with fuel here and our next point of interest to call in. Half a mile up the road, it's the Bean Ager Visitor Centre.
Heading out of Kinlochhue, we've picked up the A832 heading northwesterly. Ben Ager is well signposted on the left. It was, in fact, Britain's very first national nature reserve. For those of you who've got a fair bit of time on your hands, there are woodland trails or mountain trails to explore, which are open all year round. And there's a free entry visitor centre that's open from April to October. Inside the visitor centre, there are various displays and information about the surrounding local area, so you can learn about the mountains, the ancient pine forest, Loch Marie, and all about the wildlife which can be found round here. There's Stephen Smith taking it all in. And here I am comparing my wingspan to that of a life-sized white-tailed eagle. One interesting fact that we did learn, apparently the fastest bird of prey is a peregrine falcon, which can reach speeds of up to 240 miles an hour when it's diving for prey. Fantastic.
Two viewpoints, one south and one north of Gairloch, and then we've got the hotel.
We'll get there about
5-ish.
Mind you, if we're going to stop, it's going to be like,
oh,
for
fuck
goodness.
Yeah.
What was that?
That was splish.
What
the hell is that?
That's what I have to put up with at night.
Yeah. Oh, I'll tell you. He says that, you'll hear, come on.
Thanks for that, Patrick. I think it's about time we left the National Nature Reserve at Bean Eiger to continue up the A832 alongside Loch Marie, 10 miles to our next stop at the Victoria Falls. At over 13 miles long, Loch Marie is the fourth largest freshwater loch in Scotland, and it contains 65 islands, many of which are important for wildlife as there are many bird breeding grounds. As well as salmon and trout in the Loch Marie waters, it's also an ideal habitat for otters. And here comes the gang. They've already chalked off 70 miles of the North Coast 500 official route today. And those that have rowed up from Northampton on Friday morning have now clocked up an amazing 770 miles so far on this trip. Okay, Steve, so you're enjoying yourself in Scotland, just having a leisurely cruise on your scooter in the sunshine past Loch Marie. There was a little bit of an incident that happened. Can you go into a little bit more detail for us what exactly happened?
Yeah, I was just going around the corner and I was just looking for the parking space. And out the bloody blue, this drone hit me straight in the nose, the pillock.
Victoria Falls are hidden away in Atterdale Forest. It's a short walk up to the purpose-built viewing platform, which gives a great view over Loch Marie and the bottom three sections of the waterfalls. But if you want to see the top section, it's well worth a wander up for a closer look.
Stopped off for a short break to look at Victoria Waterfalls, and as you can see, they are absolutely stunning. As we zoom in, we can see two of our friends, Sarah and Steve, joined by Chris and Andy, taking some pictures from above. A few of us are on the platform waving. Some of us are looking over in the distance to the beautiful Loch Marie.
We're approaching the end of day four now, just 7 miles through Kerrisdale and onto the two final viewpoints that are both worth a look at Gairloch. Then it's another 7 miles on the final leg to our hotel at Pooloo. First photo stop is at the Gairloch Beach viewpoint on the south side of Gairloch. Then on the north side of the village is the elevated other Gairloch viewpoint.
I still can't believe the surprises still keep on coming on this trip. There was the Harry Potter train, then the Royal Marines. We've had dramatic waterfalls and mountain passes. I wonder if there's any other surprises in store for us this week.
The weather's held up for another great day's riding, 109 miles, and we've all made it to Pooloo. Pooloo Hotel, reasonably priced, everything you need. We stayed here last year, lovely little place. We've even got two candidates lined up to wear the kilt for dinner tonight. Nick Wake had a bit of trouble with his spark plug and needed Sarah's assistance. And he doesn't know it yet, but Ian Rock was grassed up at Applecross when he borrowed a spanner from the van. Fantastic.
Right then, here we are on the end of day four at the Pooloo Hotel. Had a cracking day, brilliant riding, fantastic views. I'm absolutely loving this trip. Matt Knowlton, you don't know what you're missing. Get yourself signed up. Cheers now.
Hello lads and ladies, it's me again, Stella Steve.
You're a celebrity, man.
I am. I was on the Bealach Na Bá today, just starting it. I thought I'd help poor old Gary out because he's a new guy. So I stepped behind him all the way, pushing him, go. And then as we was on the long open road, stretched it, opened it up. As I pulled in front of him, he said, "You stupid boy, you nearly got yourself killed." But I'm top dogging Bealach Na Bá.
Gary loves you to bits.
You're top dogging or what?
Gary loves you to bits.
I
f***ing
spoils out
the c***
out, didn't I?
Yeah, as he bought you drinks.
Thanks for that, Stella Steve. And after a few drinks and a game of pool, that's where we end up after day four of our Sky is the Limit tour around Scotland.
again. The other way around.
Oh, yeah.
How was it? Not as terrifying as I thought it would be.
We hope you can join us tomorrow when we dodge the rain showers and brave a 200 foot high suspension bridge over a spectacular gorge. We stop off in Ullapool for lunch and some manly pears. Then in the afternoon it's a visit to the Knockham Crag, then on to Ardvet Castle at Loch Lomond, and finally the Wailing Widow Waterfall before we head off to our next stopover at Loch Inver, where Chris takes a dip in the Minch. See you next time on our Sky the Limit 2021 tour around Scotland.
Come on, Scotland!